Hey everybody, welcome back to Spyro Year of the Dragon. In the last video, we did Bentley's Outpost, and then we went back to Midday Gardens and did the rest of Bamboo Terrace, like the Bentley part of that level. And then in this video, we're gonna head to Frozen Altars. You ready?
Yep.
Yeah, this is a really, I'm gonna say cool level, but no.
It is.
It's actually a really fun level. This is probably one of my favorites in this world.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Welcome to Frozen Altars, Spyro. On behalf of the Ice Fairies, I want to grant you a special power for as long as you stay in our world.
Okay, now this is a very cool feature of this level. Instead of fire breath, you have ice breath, which, like she said, returns back to normal when you leave this level.
Mm-hmm.
But it actually works really well because it can help you against certain enemies. It actually helps you reach higher areas in this world too, because you can freeze enemies and NPCs too,
yeah.
Which you'll see in a bit. Before we move on though, I'm gonna talk to this. I guess he's a chicken. Oh shoot!
I don't know what he's supposed to be, like a duck or a.
He has like that. Oh man, I don't know what you call that thing on his
head.
Yeah,
the rooster thing.
Yeah, the comb, I guess.
Yeah.
All right.
I don't know what he is.
He spins it around. That's awesome. All right.
Some bear sold us a laser defense system to protect us from Rhinox, but with these flippers, I can't even turn it on. You'd have no trouble using it, though. Just walk inside. When you're done, press the triangle button and you'll walk back out.
These guys are all voiced by Tom Kenny, but they all talk in that whisper. But
yeah.
You can use this laser defense system to defeat some enemies. You can actually defeat all these enemies like on your own, but it's more fun using this. I love using this thing. I think that's every... Oh, wait. And then the ice.
Yeah.
There we go. Can I reach him?
No, I don't think so.
He's too far.
When I get my flippers on that rotten bear.
Well, it should be pretty obvious who he's referring to. But, oh, shoot. I shouldn't have knocked that guy out. There's actually something funny you can do with them. There's more of those guys, though. Oh, yeah.
Right here.
Try not to get hit. I usually get hit by these guys. they moon you if you get rid of their, source of power, I guess.
Yeah. Actually, that's kind of a throwback to the first Spyro game where the enemies in Peacekeeper did that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think it's the same animation, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember when we did that playthrough, that was fun.
Yeah. Oh, that was weird.
Yeah, those guys hit me all the time.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's interesting because, like, usually with the big enemies, you just flame them.
Mm-hmm.
But since you have the frost breath, you have to freeze them and then charge them.
Is there a fodder around here?
I don't think there's been any fodder yet. I haven't seen any.
Oh, well. Okay. Actually, another thing that you're going to do a lot in this level is, like, gliding from, like, these rooftops.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of gems up here.
Yeah.
I don't think we have access to anything yet. There's actually... directly across here, you have to go on like on top of that, on those stairs in that temple. But that's well, actually, no, I could do that now. It's really just like right here. But I'm gonna take care of some of these enemies first.
Oh, there's the fodder. It's like a kiwi bird.
Yeah.
Thing.
It's like pink, bright pink.
Yeah.
You remember that time period in like the, was it like late 80s, or early 90s? Well, early 90s for you, but like. Neon was like everywhere, like everything. They had like those what are those folders with like the bright animals?
Lisa Frank.
Yeah.
That could have definitely been a Lisa Frank kiwi bird.
Did you have those?
Not really. I think actually something that my mom got for me and my sister to do on like long car rides, she would get these posters that had like certain areas were white and you could like color them in with markers, and the black part was like velvety.
Yeah, my sister had those.
Yeah, so. I think she got like me, I think I had like two dolphins on it. It was like a Lisa Frank thing. Oh. I colored one of the dolphins blue and one of them purple.
Nice.
Eustace and I were having a snowman building competition when the sorceress brought them to life with a spell. Since then, they've been stomping around, building ice walls, and generally causing trouble.
Okay, so we have another laser system to use here, and you can actually take care of the snowman, and they make a funny noise.
Yeah.
Like, oh, there we go. Can you defeat them without this? I never tried.
Yeah, you can't. Because since they're...
Oh, sorry.
Since they're snowmen, they're, like, not hurt by your ice breath, and then they're too big for you to just charge, so...
Yeah, they're pretty scary looking, too.
Yeah.
Okay. Actually, there is something to do there. I'm just going to grab this real quick. There we go. Before I forget. But as we were talking about earlier, you can actually freeze some of the NPCs. Don't worry. He's going to be okay.
Mm-hmm.
And get up to, like, higher parts. I think he thaws out.
Yeah. It'll be fine.
Yeah. I can't remember if they do an animation when they thaw out. I might test that out later.
Yeah. I think they, like, when the ice melts, they're like, woo.
See. Oh, let me get these first. I just saw these out of the corner of my eye.
Ooh.
Yeah, that was, yeah. Yeah. Let's get this egg first. What do we have here? Cecil. Or Cecil, whatever. I can't remember what cartoon that was, but somebody was named...
Baby.
It was spelled like Cecil, but they called it Cecil or something like that.
Oh, weird.
I can't remember what cartoon that was.
I think you have to go up there a second time.
Oh.
To get on that rooftop.
Oh, yeah. Did he do it?
Yeah, he, like, melted. You could hear, like, the ice. It, like, makes, like, a...
Did he do, like, the brr thing?
I think so. I think you can talk to him afterwards, too, and he says something.
That was it for over here. Right?
I think you can glide to that rooftop. No, not that one.
The one on the right. Okay, yeah. Oh, shoot. I just remember, like, as I was gliding. That's all right. We'll just go around. But yeah, this is the first instance, I think, because you didn't have ice powers in Ripto's Rage, right? It was just flame and then the super flame thing.
Mm-hmm.
But this would pop up in later Spyro games, too, like the post-Insomniac stuff. I don't need that.
Yeah. I think they call it Frost Breath in Enter the Dragonfly.
Mm-hmm. They had the electricity, too. Oh, he didn't do anything.
Yeah, he just...
I knew we should have bought the automated laser defense system.
Oh, he doesn't say anything different either. I think it's the guy, like, further ahead that'll say something about it.
Yeah, I'll test it out on him, too. It's pretty cool how, like, you see it, like, the ice melt, like, the ice cube. Okay, so the one straight ahead here.
Yeah.
Bunch of red gems, and that's it. Actually, is there... I know there's more stuff, like, across there, but
I think that's,
you have to go around.
Right.
Yeah. Okay, but yeah, the frost breath is pretty neat, or whatever they call it in this game.
Yeah.
I think it's neat that he had different breath things in End of the Dragonfly, even though...
Yeah, that's probably the only positive that I can think of for it.
Yeah, and they utilize it a lot. Like, you had to use, like, frost breath on certain enemies, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And then the...
They had electricity breath, too.
Mm-hmm. Gosh, these guys, I think there's a... Oh, it always throws me off when,
It would be easy to get up to that treasure if you had something to stand on.
Okay, I'll stand on you.
Since you volunteered.
You can also stand on the enemies, too, if they're close enough. That's actually what I did the first time. I was like, man, how are you supposed to get that? And I was like, oh.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh, he landed, like, kind of weird.
Yeah. I think he does that when you charge him, too.
Is this the guy?
Yeah. If you talk to him, he says something.
Oh, okay.
Purr. I don't know why, but I feel really cold.
I think they talk funny.
Yeah, they do.
I think Tom Kenny had some fun with that one. Oh, these guys. Oh. I was gonna try to get him to moon, but he was already attacking.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have one of those, I guess they're like these elephant things.
Mm-hmm.
And then like there's another snowman.
Mammoth or something.
Yeah. Oof, oh, he got me. I'm gonna freeze him like that. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna grab some of these gems and then I'll destroy that snowman. Let me get a close-up of him.
He looks crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, you can land, like, on the same platform as him, but he'll, like, try to chase you off.
Yeah,
he's scary. I used to be really scared of those guys.
I'll ignore that guy. Oh, we're gonna go in here, and then I'll take care of that elephant down there, too. Wow. Come on. There we go. I like how they just pop, too.
Yeah.
And I think that's all the destructible stuff.
Yeah.
Well, even though Moneybags ripped the bird guys off, that works well for us.
Yeah.
We can actually use that
definitely
to our advantage. Oh, there's a Bentley. Oh my gosh. That area. Okay, actually, I mentioned this in the, I don't remember if it was the last video or the one before that, but that skill point is one of the more difficult ones.
Yeah, I would go to as far to say it's the hardest.
It's up there. I don't know what's harder, that one or that tower one. I'm probably gonna say I don't know.
Yeah, people think that one's hard. I don't remember having that hard of a time with it.
But yeah, that Bentley skill point is tough.
Yeah.
It's gonna take me a couple tries. I already know that. All right, we have another defense system here. Like how the pitch changes with each hit. There we go. It
gets like lower, I think.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Let me get this guy up here.
Yeah. I think you can even get the baskets in the phases. There's a fodder down there.
There we go. Might as well get him too. Sorry. He's like, I don't want to.
He's like, hide it.
Yeah, he is. Come on.
Maybe you can't get him like that. Hmm. I don't know.
It's kind of weird. He's, like, protected by some, like, divine shield, invisible shield or something. All right, well, I do need to take care of him anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't freeze. They just straight up
die.
Yeah. Okay, so let's get all the gems that spawn. There's quite a few of them. Oh, missed these back here. Oh, I'll go back to that. That's an that's the hockey thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, man, when I was playing this the other day, in like a non-recording file, I practiced on that hockey thing. I got it down. Like I got it on my first try, but oh shoot. But I don't know if that's gonna happen here again.
Yeah. I think that part's much easier than the Bentley part.
Yeah, I mean, getting the two eggs, you get two eggs from there. That's not too bad. It's the skill point that's like,
mm-hmm.
like grading, I guess. There we go.
I think they're both pretty difficult.
Wait, was there anything up there?
Yeah.
Oh shoot. Yeah, I wasn't sure, so I just kind of didn't really jump that well. But yeah, I'll go back up there. I feel like I took care of most of the enemies here now.
Yeah, I don't think there's any more.
Okay, and I'm gonna jump over here. I'm trying to remember what's over here. This is probably just more gems, right?
That's the egg.
Oh, okay. Jasper. What's up, Jasper? Another dog-like animation.
Yeah.
Alright. So he's probably pointing to that hockey thing?
Yeah.
Actually, that thing respawn? Oh, yeah. Actually, that fireworks factory level, that's kind of tough sometimes because it doesn't seem like the fodder respawns that much.
Yeah.
If at all. Alright. Oh, let me get these real quick. We have another bird to talk to. Oh, that's everything.
Mm-hmm.
Well, all the gems, and then we have the eggs. Actually, is it just one from the hockey?
I think, one from the hockey and two from the Bentley. And then one for completing the, like, if you talk to the bird.
He gives for the snowman thing.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're done with the gem collecting. All right, let's talk to the bird over here.
Thanks for helping out, Spyro. Why don't you take this? The Rhinox were trying to fry it with a laser, but you stopped them just in time.
Okay, so he's out of here. This is actually a shortcut back to the beginning.
I kind of like that they did that in a lot of these levels. They have, like, something that takes you back to the beginning, just in case, like, you miss something.
Yeah, I definitely used this the first time I went through this level because I didn't know about the stuff on the rooftops.
Uh-huh.
Well, not all of them, so I had to come back here and, like, climb and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Okay, but now let's talk to Moneybags.
Say, Spyro, you're a sports fan, aren't you? As you probably know, Frozen Altars is the birthplace of the great sport of cat hockey. Today's match is sold out, of course, but I just happen to have a spare ticket that I'll sell you for, say, a teensy-weensy markup. Head on in, Spyro. It should be a thrilling match. In fact, I've even placed a little wager on the Rhinox team. Let's just hope the local team doesn't have any last-minute accidents.
Jeez, what a jerk. Oh, you can't freeze him. I never tried, but nah, you can't. All right, so he takes 200 gems. That was 200, right?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay, so let's head in. Okay, this is cat hockey. This guy is probably going to explain what to do.
Wait, it wasn't 200.
Really? Oh, I thought I had
4,000. You had 4,000 when you started, and then you got 600 from the level.
Oh,
so it was 800.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah.
Oh, because we started. Didn't we start out with 4,000?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so that's what threw
me off. So then you added 600.
Gotcha. Then,
yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's see. Learn the rules of cat hockey.
I challenged a Rhinox to a traditional game of cat hockey, but I think I sprained my flipper during training. Would you mind taking my place? Great. Freeze the cats and push them into my goal to score.
Yeah, this is definitely different than the Colossus hockey match, but this is actually pretty funny, too, because the cats look so goofy.
Yeah, but you gotta treasure cats, almost.
Yeah, exactly. The same design and everything. But you gotta freeze the cats. Oh, shoot, he scored already. And then push them into the blue goal. Oh, shoot, I thought he was gonna go in. Ah, it's so slippery, though.
Yeah.
I don't know what strategy you use, but I don't really have one. He's beating me. You can freeze him, too.
Yeah.
But he doesn't stay frozen for that long.
Mm-mm.
See, the easiest thing, I think, is when they go towards the middle.
Oh, yeah.
Shoot.
Create that one.
Yeah.
There you go. And they stay in there. There's actually a little scratching post.
You know, I didn't notice that until after I beat him the first time. But yeah, it's pretty cute. There you go. Nice.
Oh no!
He's gonna score. Jeez.
How is he freezing them? Oh, I don't think that one actually went in his thing.
Yeah,
Hopefully it melts and like gets away.
Yeah. But yeah, I was thinking about that too right before you said it. And I was like, what the heck? Because he just walked in front of it and it froze.
Yeah.
That's
nice.
Well done. I think you deserve to keep the Champions Cup. You gave that Rhinox such a drubbing. He's retired from the sport for good.
Oh yeah, let's check that out. Yeah, you can see them on the scratching post.
It's pretty cute.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I don't know about you or anybody watching, but that, what's his name, Ba-a.
Yeah.
That threw me off the first time because I was like, whoa, is there a sheep egg? I was like, that doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
But then it was like a fake costume thing. Okay, so two eggs left, and it's the Bentley one.
Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, this is probably going to take me a while. Actually, oh yeah, here it is. This is going to take me a while. I'm letting everybody know in advance. I'm probably going to... The first round one shouldn't be too bad. It might take me a couple tries, but the one after that, the second egg, is going to take me a while, and even more probably for that skill point. So just letting everybody know in advance, I'm probably going to skip ahead a couple times. Okay.
Ah, Spyro. I've just received word from my little brother. He appears to be having some trouble with a yeti.
Fat dumb yeti took my ball. I told him to give it back or you'd kick his lousy butt, but he wouldn't listen. I knew you'd do it. Go and show him not to mess with us. Remember to block his eye punches and hit him low when he tries to block.
Oh boy, here we go. Mm-hmm. You have to beat him in a boxing match, and I am not good at this at all.
No, I'm actually worse at it than you are, so... Because I didn't really play that many fighting games or anything like that.
Yeah. See, the thing that makes this difficult for me is he doesn't telegraph his moves. He kind of just does stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like punch-out.
He, like, always blocks you, too. It's so annoying.
Yeah, he knows what you're going to do in advance, basically.
By the way, does he look familiar to you?
He was in a level in Ripto's Rage, right?
He was in Colossus.
Okay. Oh, they were the... Oh, shoot, I lost.
You lost? But how am I going to get my ball back? You've got to try again. I knew you'd do it. Go and show him not to mess with us. Remember to block his eye punches and hit him low when he tries to block.
Okay. Second attempt. But, oh, shoot. I can't remember what I was going to say anymore. It'll come back to me, I guess. Oh, yeah, what was up with him in Colossus? I know, like, he showed up at the end, right?
Yeah, he was at the end. They were trying to get him, like, out, and you were, like, supposed to fight him, but, like...
The thing landed on
him.
Oh, yeah, wow. Yeah, I'm winning this time.
Yeah.
I got lucky with that block.
Yeah.
I didn't know what he was doing.
Get you against the...
Yeah, that's the worst.
Oh, there you go.
There we go. So that's down.
You really showed him. Hey, wait a minute. This isn't my ball. We should go back and kick his butt again. Make him give me my ball back. This time it'll be a three-round match, and when you win, don't let him send you off with a stupid egg.
Okay, and this is where the skill point comes into play. You have to beat him within three rounds, but the skill point, you beat him in two.
Yeah, it's pretty difficult.
Yeah, oh man. The other day when I was practicing this, it took probably 7 or 8 tries, I want to say.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it was brutal. Because you have to make sure that you have a pretty decent amount of health, and his health has to be a certain amount by the end of round one.
I think, like, you should at least aim for half.
Yeah.
Because what happens is after you finish a round, you actually get some health back,
yeah,
and
both
so
of
does
you.
He.
Right. Oof, man. Oh, yeah, so, by the way, this all started because of, like, a ball.
Yeah.
Like Bartholomew sounds like a grown man.
It's
okay.
Well, he is your younger brother.
Yeah. I just thought that was weird. Oh, shoot. I'm not going to do it this time.
Yeah.
It's gonna take like a miracle. I have to like not get hit ever. Jeez. And he got a lot of free shots at the end there. Okay, I'm gonna skip that. I don't really care what he says. Look.
Oh my gosh, his health's almost full.
Yep. Another thing, I mean, I don't really have the good tips for this. The best thing I could tell you is, like, you don't want to hit the whole time. You want to block some of them.
Yeah.
Or try to. And also move around, because if you just stand still, he's just going to beat your head in.
And definitely try to not be, like, in the corner or against the wall. Yeah. Like, if he starts coming at you like he's trying to box you in, like, try to get around
him. Yeah. I've been in a corner before, and he just, like, beats your head in.
Yeah, he wails you.
You also want to try to get these big hits in, because you can hit them with like the quick jabs, but they don't do that much damage.
Yeah. The only criticism I have about the big hit is that it takes a while to wind up, so he can possibly hit you before you hit him.
Yep.
That's why the jab is pretty useful.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you're doing some damage, so it's not useless. Oh, he's gonna beat me here. I might as well. I was gonna let him beat me because I'm
start
like,
over.
Yeah, I just want to get the fight.
Can
and
you
skill
quit?
Point. Exit area.
Exit.
Yeah. Because I think in that case you have to do the first fight over again, right?
Yeah.
Oh man. I'm just gonna let him beat me here.
Oh wait, I don't know if you have to do the first fight over because,
he like doesn't want to fight anymore.
I know.
Come on, just knock me out. There you go. Alright, but I'm probably going to skip ahead after this. Well, I'll do one more attempt. We'll see what happens.
You lost.
Yeah. Oh. I started trying to start out with that, but you saw that coming. And the game's supposed to automatically block low for you, but that doesn't always happen. Well, I guess
you have to be like standing still.
Yeah, completely still. Yeah.
Kind of silly.
So yeah. Oh. I don't want to be in this corner. He's kicking my butt. But yeah, this isn't like Punch-Out. I don't know if you ever played that on the NES.
No,
like,
I haven't.
Like, your opponents all choreograph what move they're going to do. So you can like, dodge or block in advance.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, sometimes it's, like, super quick, so you got to be... It's not like, you know, you always know what they're going to do.
Yeah.
This is more difficult. Well, not more difficult overall. That game's way harder.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, this is... I hate this thing.
Yeah.
I don't think I'm gonna do it this time. He has way too much health.
Oh my gosh.
He's getting all these hits in. Come on. Oof. I managed to stop that big hit. Yeah. I mean, at the very least, I could try to do the 3-round thing, but actually, my health is way too low, so I don't even think I'm gonna do that. Jeez. Oof. Alright. Get the rest of this here. I mean, I'll try to get this done in the third round. At least get the egg, but...
Well, after you get the egg, can you still get the skill point?
Pretty sure you can. I think that happened the other day. Like, I beat him in 3 rounds, but not the 2. Hmm. Like whiff like crazy there.
Yeah.
Alright, I got him down to like a lower amount of health, but it's gonna be brutal. Ah. way too intense. Oh my god. Oof. Got him.
Oh, nice. Wow.
I think that was I was one punch it.
Yeah.
Away from failing.
Hey! This isn't my ball! It's just another stupid egg!
Okay, trying this again. It turns out that after, if you do like the 3-round thing and don't get the skill point, you have to leave the level and then come back and then do both matches over again. So, yeah, just you should probably just try for the skill point.
Yeah.
And if you get to the 3rd round, just fail on purpose.
That's what I usually do. I didn't think that you could fight him again afterwards, so...
Yeah, I thought you could, but I was definitely mistaken. And try to get him at least to half health here.
Yeah. You're doing pretty good.
Yeah, he keeps walking to some of these punches. Ooh. Oh, he's trying to catch up here. What? I mean, he missed me, but I didn't think I'd miss him, too. Oh, shoot. I was hoping to get one more hit in there. Okay, he's like about, maybe, he had a fourth of his health left, so he's going to have a little over half, I think, when he gets his health back. Yeah. Nah, he...
Less than you.
Yeah. Oh, he always gets me in this corner, man. Or I always walk into the corner.
Yeah, you do.
It's just a habit. It's like with some fighting games. There we go.
Nice.
Trying to be mindful of the time too.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't matter how much HP he has left. If the time runs out, then you're done.
Mm-hmm. I think you can get him.
Hopefully. Unless he goes like crazy.
Nice.
Yeah, those big punches are gonna help him out.
Oh, one more. Just jab him.
There we go.
You got him.
Yeah. Oof.
Nice.
And you got the skill point. Man, that was crazy. Okay, we already got this egg though.
Yeah.
Rico. All right, so that is it.
Yep.
We're done with Frozen Altars, and I got that stupid skill point out of the way. Man, I don't like that one.
No.
I mean,
I think it's the hardest one. Some people can say the Impossible Tower for Charmed Ridge is hard, but no, I think that one's the hardest.
Alrighty. Anyway, we are done with that level, and in the next video, we're going to get to... Actually, what is the next one?
Don't we have to go to Honey Speedway?
Yeah, because... Yeah. Oh, yeah. There's a reason for that. We'll talk about that in the next video, though.
Mm-hmm.
All right, everybody. Thank you for watching. See you next time.
Bye.